हेलो क्लास सेवन, गुड मॉर्निंग। इन लास्ट डे वी स्टार्टेड चैप्टर एट, क्यू बेसिक कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट। सो वी डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज अ क्यू बेसिक लैंग्वेज एंड सम फीचर्स ऑफ क्यू बेसिक। क्यू बेसिक लैंग्वेज वाज डेवलप्ड 1975 बाय बिल गेट्स एंड पॉल एलन। इट्स फुल फॉर्म इज क्विक बेसिक क्विक बिगिनर्स ऑल पर्पज सिम्बॉलिक इंस्ट्रक्शन कोड। नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न three conditional statements of QBasic and how to use these statements in the program. The first conditional statement is if-then statement. It is called if-then and if statement. Second is if-then else statement. What is second one? If-then else statement. And third is if-then else if statement. So today we are going to discuss the first one. So there are mainly three conditional statements: if then statement, if then else statement, and if then else if statement. Now what is if then statement? The if and then commands are used to check a condition. It is used to check a condition and then perform the task based on the given condition. It checks the condition. If condition is true, listen carefully, if condition is true, then it executes the statement. What is the following statements? If condition is false, it does nothing. Nothing will be done if condition is false. So once again, the if and then commands are used to check a condition and then perform the task. See the syntax. If after if condition is true, then this statement will be executed. If condition is false, then this statement will not be executed. Okay? And after that, at last, we have to write and if. This is the end of the if statement. Once again, what is syntax? What is the form? If condition, then statement, and if. That if condition is true, then a statement is executed. Otherwise, nothing is executed. So this was the syntax. Now, see some examples. Like first example, if n greater than 0, if any number is greater than 0, then it is a positive number. Clear? If a number is greater than 0, then it is positive number, and if a number is less than 0, then it is a negative number. And if n is greater than 0, then print n is a positive number. And if, so suppose you have given the number 5, the 5 is greater than 0, yes, 5 is greater than 0, the 5 is a positive number. Okay. Second example, if suppose you have given, once again see, if you have given -8, number is -8, the -8 is greater than 0, no, condition false. So nothing will be printed. This line will not execute. Just it will come without doing anything. Second example, if A is greater than 15, if the value of A is greater than 15, then print A is greater than 15. So suppose A value is 20. A value is 20. The 20 is greater than 15. Yes, 20 is greater than 15. So it will print that A is greater than 15. Again, suppose you have given 5. The 5 is greater than 15. No, condition false. 5 is not greater than 15. So nothing will be printed. So it is very simple. Once again, see the if statement, the if and then conditions are used to check a condition. This condition will be checked, and if condition is true, the statement following will be executed. If condition is false, nothing is executed. And to check this condition, we use the relational operator. To check the condition, what is used? We use the relational operator. We have 6 relational operators in QBasic. Earlier also we have studied. If the statements uses relational operators to compare the quantities. Now see, this is greater than sign. So this sign is used to check whether the first value is greater than second or not. So it is called greater than. This sign is called less than. It is used to check whether the first quantity is greater than, is less than second or not. This is equal to sign. This checks whether both the quantities are equal or not. And this sign, look here, this sign. This sign is called greater than or equal to. In the math we write like this. The sign is called greater than or equal to sign. It is used to check whether the first quantity is greater than or equal to second or not. It checks for both. Greater than or equal to second or not. If it is either greater than or equal to, condition will be true. Okay? This is called less than equal to sign. So this less than equal to sign checks whether the first quantity is either less than or equal to second quantities or not. And this one, this less than sign and greater than sign together, it is called not equal to. This sign is called not equal to. It checks whether the first value, first quantity is not equal to second or not. Like see, if I write 5 not equal to 7, condition will be true. Condition will be what? True. If I write 5 not equal to 5, then condition will be false. Understood? So to check the condition, we use this relational operator. There are 6: greater than, less than, equal to, greater than equal to, less than equal to, and not equal to. So in today's class, what we have learned? We have learned that what is the if-then statement. It checks the condition and then performs the task based on the given condition. We have discussed the syntax and how to write in our program. This way we can write in our program. And to check the condition, which operators are used? Relational operators are used to check the condition, to check the quantities. Thank you.